There's nowhere you won't go, nothing you won't do, no place that I could hide. You're always in pursuit. I'm never too far gone, always in your side. When I wait for you, you're always right on time. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. You made a way for me, opened up the door. Jesus, you have my heart, now and forevermore. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. Your love is chasing, your love is chasing, your love is chasing me. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. Oh, your love is chasing, your love is chasing, your love is chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop.
like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before.
Kiddos, it's good to see you. If you remember correctly, I accidentally locked myself in a museum, so I'm stuck here all day, hours. I'll tell you what, for the most part, it's been pretty cool. I've discovered the ocean section, I climbed up a T-Rex's bone nose, I even played frisbee with a plate that was over 2,000 years old, and I still would have been playing with it if it wouldn't have broke, but oh well. But I'll be honest, I got a problem now. I am hungry. For real, I've been walking around this museum and I am shocked about all the things that are making me hungry. For example, do you know what a pyramid looks like? Basically four slices of pizza stacked against one another. Or an airplane, for example. If you squint your eyes just right, doesn't it look like two breadsticks just stacked upon one another? Golly, all this museum talk is just making my hunger and thirst even greater. Ah! Hey! Look at this. Apparently this is a 1,000-year-old chip. This thing was made on a boat by the Vikings. And I can imagine this thing tastes just as bad as it smells. But a man's gotta eat. Here we go. Yum, it tastes like war, beard hair, and marshmallow? Overall, not bad for something that might make me sick and send me to the doctor. Now for something to wash it down. Yes. Now apparently this bowl was made in Egypt hundreds of years ago. The water inside of it was there when they found it. So this water is super, super old. And they said right here that if this water is drunk, it could be death fly. Huh, I wonder if that means I'll get superhuman powers. Let's see.
Carl, don't!
Ah!
Whew, that was a close one, Carl.
What are you talking about? Oh. What are you talking about?
The water is incredibly dangerous to drink, Carl. You could have got hurt.
How in the world do you know?
It says if you drink it, it could be deadly.
Oh, very good. Thanks, Andy.
No worries, man. I'm glad you're okay. But, so what's up with you? Are you still stuck at the museum?
Yep. Looks like I'll be spending the whole day in here. It's been a little tough, but the 1,000-year-old cracker made me feel a little better. Well, it's funny because that bowl of water reminded me of Jesus' first miracle.
Really? What was his first miracle? I'm trying to think. It was when he walked on water, right?
No, it was at a wedding.
Really? A wedding?
Oh, yeah. It was cool.
Well, what happened?
Well, Jesus was with his mother, Mary, at a wedding in a place called Galilee.
Oh, so it was like Jesus' family getting married?
I'm honestly not sure. But shortly after they got there, the whole wedding ran out of wine.
So there was nothing left to drink? Man, that is definitely not what you would want at your wedding.
Right! So Mary runs over to Jesus and said, "Hey, Jesus, we're out of wine! We need help!" Something like that. And Jesus was like, why is that my problem, Mom?
Did he really say that?
Not quite, but Jesus didn't really see it as something that he needed to fix, but...
But what?
But he did anyway. Mary looked at the servants and told them, "Hey, do everything that Jesus tells you to do."
Are they gonna just run to the store and get some more?
It wasn't that simple. Jesus told the servants to take 6 stone jars and fill them up with water.
Wait, hold up. How big were these jars?
Big. These things held like 20 to 30 gallons each. So when they're full, they are super heavy.
For sure, but don't they need more wine, not water?
Yep.
But Jesus is telling them to get water, right?
You got it.
I'm confused.
Well, this is where it gets awesome. They bring the water jugs back, they pull a little water out of it and take it whoever's in charge of the wedding, and guess what?
He was confused too because it was still water?
Nope. It was now wine. And they said it was better than what they had earlier. Jesus turned water into wine.
Whoa, that's incredible. How did he do that? Because I'm not gonna lie, if I could turn water into chocolate milk, I'd probably be the happiest person alive.
Well, the only way that Jesus was able to do that was because he had God's spirit inside of him. Jesus was giving us a small sample of what God can do.
Wow, just like Jesus transformed that water into wine, he could also transform our hearts into what God wants for us.
Yes, and this is why it's one of my favorite stories. Also because it was a wedding, and weddings have cakes. Man, I'm hungry again.
Hey there, kiddos. This week's big idea is something special. It's Jesus gives us a taste of God's power. So let's say it all together. But because sometimes it's very quiet in a museum, let's try whispering it, okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3. Jesus gives us a taste of God's power. Great job, kids. Now, thanks for listening so well to today's story. Now, I think I might need to go and talk to Carl and see if I can help him out. So we will see you on our next episode of Grow TV. See you next time.
Superman faster than the Flash, bigger than the Hulk, man, Jesus.